everybody, and welcome to Water STEM Live, the science of what's possible for kids. My name is Jennifer Fournier, and I work out of our Milford, Massachusetts headquarters. But today, I'm at home with my three children, Lincoln, who is 9, Isabella, who is 6, and Jackson, who is 11. And we're excited to bring to you today an experiment that is at the core of what we do at Waters Corporation, which is liquid chromatography, otherwise known as separation science. The key theme today is hydrophobicity. So that's a big word, and what does that mean? Well, I'm gonna use two examples. So if you use an example of, say, a dog really, typically, dogs like water. So if we take an example of a dog, Isabella, or Lincoln. So dogs like water, therefore we would say that they are more hydrophilic. So hydro meaning water, philic meaning like. If we take another example, maybe let's use cats. Do you have a cat, Isabella? So cats typically don't like water. And so in that case, we would say that they're hydrophobic. So again, water, but not liking it. So like a phobia, phobic. So today we're going to apply those principles of hydrophobicity, so hydrophilic, I like water, hydrophobic, I don't like water, to the experiment called pen peculiarities. So in this experiment, we're going to take a look at chromatography of ink. So we have a wide variety of markers that we're going to go through. So in the material list that we had posted on Facebook Live, we have a bunch of different materials. And I'll actually go through some adaptations in case you don't have these materials at home. But for today, we're going to use our white coffee filters. So that's a good chromatographic material. We would call it stationary phase at Waters. You can also use white paper towels. Those work really good. White napkins work good. I did try tissues. Those don't work as good. But definitely any of those three things, if you have them in your home, you can use them as what we would call our stationary phase. So you need to make sure that you have one of those things. The other key component, I told you that we do liquid chromatography. So that means you need liquid. So in our glasses, and you can use any type of glass at home. So you can see we were lucky enough. We found some clear, long glasses. So we could actually see what's going on, and we just put a little bit of water in each of those glasses before we jumped on to the live. So you don't need a lot of water because you don't want to submerge your sample, but you just need a little bit of water at the bottom. So a glass, water, your stationary phase, which is your coffee filter, and then if you want to get fancy, again, these are optional, you can use a straw, and I'll show you what we're going to do with that, as well as a paper clip. And so this is going to hold our stationary phase in place because once these filters get wet, they can kind of go into the glass and we don't want it to ruin our experiment. So we want something to hold it up. And I don't know about you, but I don't want to be standing there all day holding up my paper towel or even for a couple minutes. So that's what these devices are going to be used for. So again, you don't have to have those. You can certainly hold your paper towel or your napkin or your coffee filter into the water if you wanted to. But we're going to use these today to show you how they work. So the first thing we're going to do is, I told you we already filled our water glass with a little bit of water. So if you're following along with us at home, you can go ahead and do that. So again, just a little bit of water. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take our straws. So you guys want to take your straws. And we're going to take our paper clip and we're just going to put the straw through the top of the paper clip. Super simple. You guys got it? Ideally, what that's gonna look like, and I have my own glass here, is that this is going to kind of sit on the top, and then the bottom of the paper clip, which is what you kind of hook papers to, that's what we're going to attach our paper towel, our napkin, or our white coffee filter to. And so you guys can have those. You're all set, great. Now let's make our stationary phase. So we have our liquid for our liquid chromatography. Now our stationary phase is what we call our filter paper. So this you want to make sure when you're measuring and you're cutting, you just want to have it be the height of whatever container you're using. So if you guys want to start cutting and you want to make sure your strips aren't too thin, but aren't too thick either because they've got to fit into your glass. Thicker is better than thinner. So I'm going to show you an example of some that Isabella cut earlier. So for example, that's a really good width because you need a little bit of space for your variable, which in this case is going to be our markers, kind of move up that paper. So they are cutting right now. Good job, guys. So for each experiment, you really only need one strip of paper. But what's cool about this experiment is even after this live, you can test out a bunch of things within your home because you'll have a bunch of different strips of paper. All right, you guys good?
Mm-hmm.
Isabella, you good? Great. All right, so we pretty much have everything ready for this super simple liquid chromatography experiment. But what we're doing today is we're testing. So science has a lot of variables. So we want to test a bunch of different variables. So in the instructions that we posted, what we said is that you can use washable markers or wet erase markers. And those are key words because typically, and parents know this really well, I like to use washable markers because if they get on my table, it's easy for me to take water and wash them off. And that's because they are water soluble. So the words that I was describing before, which were hydrophobic or hydrophilic, if it's ink that's water soluble or a marker that's water soluble, that means that it's made out of materials or ink that are hydrophilic, that like water. So if it gets on mom and dad's table, it's okay. You can take water and you can make sure that it gets off of the table. If it's permanent, that typically means that water won't solubilize it. So it's going to stay on your table unless you use some other types of chemicals to get them off. So that's why it was important to try to use washable markers or wet erase markers. But actually, I'm going to go through what happens if you don't, because it's science, and even if an experiment doesn't work, that's okay, because we learn from it. So I want to engage with the audience right now, because we have a lot of different colors that we're going to do. The mandatory color, if you have at home, is black, and I'll explain why in a minute. But as I'm talking about why you'd want to use black if you have a black washable marker at home, go ahead and use the chat right now and tell us what colors you want. And we will choose the colors, and that's what we're going to test our experiment out today. Now, why do you want to use black? Well, black is key because if you go back to art classes, right, black is not really a color, right? Black is made up of a bunch of different colors. And so if you use this as your separation variable or tool and you put this on your chromatographic device, ideally the water is going to take it and it's going to separate it out into the colors that the manufacturer used to make this black ink. We recommend if you have a bunch of different types of manufacturers, so say you're using washable markers from a variety of sources, they may use different inks to make their black markers. So you can also do that as a later on experiment. So you definitely want to use black. I did this before and I'll show you what that result is. But let's see what colors. Oh, good. We have some colors coming in that you want us to see. So guys, we have three colors. Thank you guys for your engagement. So we have purple. Who wants to do purple? Isabella. Okay, Isabella's going to do purple. We have blue. Who wants to do blue? Lincoln's going to do blue. And then we have green. So Jackson will do green. All right, so you at home take whatever color markers you want to use. And what you're going to do is on your stationary phase is a little bit above, and I'll show you an example. You don't want to do it right at the bottom, but you want to do it a little bit above where your filter paper or your napkin or paper towel is going to sit in that water. All right, so you guys can make your circle. And you can do a line or a circle. We're going to do a circle today for this particular experiment. So again, you want to make sure that it's above enough so that it doesn't get submerged, because if it's water soluble and it goes, all of it goes in the water, it's just going to be in the water. So we want it to actually move up this filter paper. All right, guys. So now we're going to attach it to that holder that we created with the straw and the paper clip. So go ahead, guys. Yep. Jackson, you want to show them what you did? Just hold it up. You guys see it? So that's what it should look like. And then, good job, guys, we can start our experiment. So what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to lower that into your water. and make sure that it touches the bottom. And if it doesn't, just adjust your paper so that, again, the bottom is into the water. So like in Lincoln's case, his was a little bit too long, if you guys can see, but that's okay because now you're starting to see the water due to capillary forces is now going up because it's absorbent, right? It's going up the filter paper and it's taking, if you guys can see, it's taking that water-soluble ink with it. So that is super cool. How's yours doing, Jackson? Good, I'll show everybody what Jackson's look like. So you guys saw the blue. This is what the green is looking like. And then we will use Izzy's too. And again, if you don't have a straw or a paper towel, no big deal. You can just hold it into the water too. Good job, Izzy. So Isabella's super cool. So that's purple that you guys chose, if you can see here. So that is moving up. So we will let that sit for a while. Now, I'm going to show you what black looks like. And I did this ahead of time. So we did the black marker, and I'll show you what it looks like. So we don't know what the manufacturer used, right, for colors. But what do you guys think they could have used? What colors could make up black? In science, no guess is wrong, right? It's just a hypothesis. What do you think? Name a color.
White, yellow.
White is not a color.
Yellow, blue.
Yellow, blue. You want to guess, Izzy?
Pink.
Pink? Okay, let's see. So, if you guys can see, this was the black marker that we had. So, who guessed blue?
Me.
Good job, Jackson. So, blue is there. We see a little bit of almost like a reddish pink. So, good job, Izzy. And actually, we see a little bit of green, too. So if I let this actually work longer, because we did it right before we jumped on the live, then it would have further separated and we would have seen all the different colors that that manufacturer used to make it. So super cool. Now another thing you can do, so say you don't have washable markers at home, that's okay too, because again, in science, no experiment is ever a wrong experiment. So when I was testing this out, I actually didn't read the directions properly, and when it said wet erase marker, I just bought dry erase markers. So dry erase markers, if you've ever used those and you've tried to wipe off the boards with water, do they get off the board with water? No, they don't, because they're dry erase. So they actually just need your physical force to get it off, like an eraser. So I put a dry erase marker onto my filter paper, and actually, this is what happened. Absolutely nothing. So it didn't happen because this, the materials that they use, again, for dry erase, are what we would call hydrophobic. So they don't like water. So if the water goes and attaches to it, it's not gonna move anywhere because it's hydrophobic. And so I highly recommend that if you have some of those in your house too, give it a try and see if it works. The other cool thing I tried, and actually, do you guys have an extra? Jax, you want to do another one? Because we'll do one more before we go. Because as a parent, right, I have washable markers, but I also have markers that aren't washable. But is it as bad as a dry erase marker? So actually, let's try a blue non-branded washable marker. So I'm going to have Jackson do that. Yep, and actually, I'll show them your final experiment. So this is the green. Oh, and super cool. Can you guys see the blue that started to come off? So it took a little bit of time. That blue really likes the water. It's very hydrophilic. It's a very hydrophilic dye. And we saw that when we compared it to our black ink. So super cool, Jackson. Actually, so the blue is green. You had blue, right?
I had green.
So, oh, you had green. Okay. I forget. Lincoln had blue. So blue, if you can see, that was what his experiment was. So good job, Link. And then Izzy, ooh, yours is pretty. So yours had some pink in it. So if you guys can see that. So good choices, audience. So for our last little experiment, we're gonna try this non-washable branded blue. And it's gonna take a little bit of time to have that go up. But as you can see, if you guys can see it, guess what, parents? If you actually have these markers, all is not lost if it gets onto your surfaces, because believe it or not, it's not completely permanent ink. And so it looks like there is some, it's not moving as fast as the washable marker. That spread out almost immediately, right, Lincoln? Mm-hmm. This one isn't moving as fast as we compare it to Lincoln's, but it's still moving. So again, there's still hope if you use your non-washable branded markers. So that is the end of our pen peculiarities experiment. Again, it's super simple, and the basic principles are hydrophobicity, so things that like water and things that don't like water. So it's really important when you go through this. Again, science can never get a wrong answer, so you can use whatever you have in your house. I encourage you to use whatever markers that you have as well. You could use pens, etc., and just experiment. So I want to thank you guys for joining us at home to do this experiment that, again, is at the core of what we do at Waters Corporation, which is liquid chromatography. And you can never stop experimenting. So thank you for joining the STEM Live. And again, happy experimenting. Bye, everybody.